Today we're going to use Arduino Mega and multi-channel relays to control 10 light bulbs that look just like this. We'll be randomly blinking 10 of these strand light bulbs. I have them on a strand, and we'll show you what you need, how to do it, the code, and application. So stick around, check it out. Hope you enjoy it. Here's everything I'll be using today. I'll be using Arduino Mega. I'll be using an 8-channel and a 2-channel 5-volt relay. I'll be using a momentary button. It's normally open. I'm using one of these power adapters, these barrel jack power adapters. You can just plug it right in here. This is perfect for a 9 or 12 volt wall adapter to provide power to your Arduino board. I'll be using 14 gauge wire when I connect my power terminal to my relays. This is a 16 to 14 gauge vinyl insulated pin terminal, and it's just a little bit too big for this. So what I do is I clamp the side of this and squeeze it just a little bit and flatten it out some, and I can slip it right in and screw it down with no problem. So I do like these. It's a great option to keep it nice and clean with good contact. I'll be using a strand of 10 of these light bulbs, and you plug these into an AC outlet, a 110 outlet. I'll be using male and female jumper cables, jumper wires. I'll be using a terminal block here to provide power to the strand of lights and to the relay for the switch to switch them on and off. This comes with it. These are like a U-shaped crimp. It creates a very nice connection inside of here, as you can see. I do recommend these. Fits real nice. Screw that down. This fork connector also comes in the package, and you screw it into one side of the block, and it provides power to all 12 positions of the terminal block. And with these crimps and stuff and your wire, you're going to need some shrink tubing. This is very cheap, but it's kind of like a multi-kit of shrink tubing. And you're going to need yourself a nice small Phillips head screwdriver. This is the plug that comes with the lights that has a fuse with a max current of 5 amp at 125 volt. I separated the hot wire from the neutral wire just past the plug, and I'll connect this section to the terminal block to provide power to all 12 positions. I connect 10 positions on the terminal block to the common screw terminal of each relay. Each relay has 3 terminals. The common is the middle terminal. Here's a diagram of what the connection will look like from the terminal block to the relay. I clip the hot wire just past each light bulb and put a crimp on the end of it. That crimp will go in the left terminal, which is the normally open terminal of the relay. And just past the next bulb on the strand, I clipped the hot wire and I crimped it, and I will plug that into the relay as well. And here's what the connections look like for the strand of bulbs, with the hot wire just past the plug going to the terminal block, and the hot wire just past each bulb will be crimped and go to the normally open terminal of the relay. You may have heard of this type of cord being referred to as zip cord. That's two insulated wires that can be pulled apart. How do you identify the neutral? Well, it's ribbed typically, and the hot wire is the smooth part. This wire here is smooth, and it has dots on it to indicate that it is the hot wire. You can also look at the tip of the plug, look at the prongs. The wider prong, the larger prong, will be the neutral. The skinnier, smaller prong will be for the hot wire. But if you're unsure, you should always check with the diagram of the appliance or plug that you're using, just to be sure. Here's my setup, and as you can see, I have pins attached to ground, IN1 through IN8, and then VCC. The ground is just connected to any ground here on the board. The IN1 through IN8 are connected through pins 2 through pin 9, respectively. So IN1 is 2, IN2 over here is connected to 3. IN3 is connected to 4, and so forth. And the same thing for this over here. I didn't see a 10-channel relay, so I had to buy a 2, an 8 and a 2. I already had the 8, and I already had the 2, so that's what I'm using. Over here, I had to set this up the same way. The first here is a VCC, and it's connected to 5 volt over here. And by the way, the VCC here, it's connected to 5 volt over here. That's a 5 volt pin. which you can see. So here, the one on the far left is a 5-volt pin, and the one next to it is a ground pin, and that is connected to ground right here. Then you got IN1 and IN2, and those are connected to pins 10 and 11.
Here's a diagram that hopefully makes it easier for you to see the connections.
I don't want to forget my button, so I plugged in the ground wire to ground right there, between the 5-volt and ground.
And the positive wire is in pin 12. Here's a diagram so you can see it clearly.
When I press the button, the relay will connect the strand of lights to power, and it'll come on.
Here's a look at how the relays activate in random order after a button press. There are 15 random relay activations with a slight pause between each one. Then there's a pause or delay that is twice as long as the previous ones before the final relay is selected. Once that's on, it stays active for 7 seconds, then goes off, and this corresponds to the blinking of the light bulbs. Here's the code that we used. It's pretty straightforward. On line 1, we indicate that there are 10 bulbs in the program. On line 2, we set up an array that lists the Arduino pins 2 through 11, which the relays are attached to. At line 3, we set the button pin at 12 for the Arduino. On line 5, we track the state of the button, whether pressed or not. Line 6 tracks the previous state of the button, and line 7 indicates if a sequence is currently active. Now we come to the setup, and this runs at the beginning when the Arduino is powered on or reset. Inside a for loop, each pin in the array is set as an output, and each relay is turned off by setting the pin to high. The button on pin 12 is set as an input with a built-in pull-up resistor. This means that the button reads high when it's not pressed and low when it is pressed. And finally, we use a random seed to generate the random numbers to produce a less predictable blinking pattern for our light bulbs. Finally, in the loop, the current state of the button pin is read and stored in the button state. If the button state is low and the last button state is high, the start random sequence function is called. And if the sequence is running, we have a delay time of 333 milliseconds and a variable flash count, which starts at 0. A while loop runs until the flash count reaches 15. A random bulb is chosen by turning a random relay on and off. And at line 43, when the while loop is finished, we have a pause that is twice the delay time. And a final bulb is randomly chosen and is on for 7,000 milliseconds or 7 seconds. And at line 53, we see the sequence has completed. Everything's connected, so we'll press the button and see the sequence of blinking lights. And it works exactly as we anticipated, so it's good. I built this for someone as an interactive game prop, but you could also use it as a random selector device, or a theatrical or stage effect device, or also a learning tool or a demonstration tool that would be creative, or holiday decorations, whether it's Halloween or Christmas. You could use it for safety training. There's a lot of different ways you can use this. You can add a motion sensor to it. It doesn't have to be a button. So use your imagination and go all out. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you found this useful in any way, be sure to like and subscribe and share it with somebody on any platform who might find a benefit to it. I'll see you again very soon.